Charanga del Norte. It is an authentic British charanga. She's here. Welcome her, please.
Charanga to come. concept of charanga was great when I was a kid growing up here in New York. Then it seemed to fade out because people foolishly thought it was old-fashioned. It wasn't salsa, which is idiotic. So I started to explore other countries playing Cuban music. And I'm going through England, and I come across Charanga del Norte.
England, of all places.
Yeah.
And it's run by this lady here named Sue Miller.
Sue Miller.
Leeds is north of London, so it's Charanga del Norte. And she sat in with us tonight here at SOV's and just blew the roof off. So why don't you tell him how you got a charanga in England?
We had the cousin of Tina, which was a nightclub, and we had visiting bands from America, from Cuba, so I saw them all, and I really liked Eddie Palmieri's music, and then I heard Cachao's Mambo, and as soon as I heard Rita de Guez off record, I bought a record off a Cuban singer, that was it. I started my charanga, I went to Cuba, found Rita de Guez, went to study with him, transcribed everything off record, arranged it, organized the band.
I didn't know that, but she named Richard Egues. Now, Richard Egues was the most famous flutist with the Orquesta Aragon, which is
Aragon, yes, Charanguera.
They've been everywhere.
All the premier charanga bands in Cuba.
Yeah. And so Egues was very
good. I went to the best.
And she studied with the best. Yeah, it was a relative of his that got Eddie Cervigón to play the flute.
It was his father, Richard Egues' father,
right,
actually taught Richard and also taught Eddie Cervigón.
Eddie Cervigón, the Broadway.
Well, Mr. Brooks, and it all comes together. She studied with the son.
I studied with Richard Egues.
Father or
the
son?
The famous, Eduardo, well, they're both called Eduardo, but okay. The late 1800s, right, is when...
Heavy though, so it's like come full circle. So
definitely,
she's here in New
York.
And I said, why don't you sit in with Charanga Soleil?
Well, I gotta tell you, I think you're gonna love the videos that I have of you playing with Charanga Soleil.
It
sounds beautiful, really, really nice.
I have to put them up on our website.
So, what is the reception? In France it would be different. You hear a lot of West Africans. How does Charanga play in London?
Well, I avoid London, actually.
You do?
I'm sorry.
We've done gigs in London, but we've done tours, we've done arts council tours from Scotland right down to Cornwall, and a lot of arts centres and theatres. So what I do is I've got a Cuban dancer called Guillermo Davis, Eliabo, and he shows the dance steps for Danzon, Cha-cha-cha, Pachanga while we play them. But he also goes into the crowd and gets them to do the conga and dancing,
right,
and stuff. So we animate it like that. And in the theatres, I tell people what the words mean. Like, hay que frío, busco un muchacho para casarme.
Right.
Este frío que me está pasando. You know, it's like, I need a man to marry just to keep me warm.
Yeah.
And so I make a joke and I teach people about the song and the style, but in a fun way. So it gives them a way in because, you know, most people don't speak Spanish.
Well, she was able to pull something off. How many CDs do you have out?
That was going to be my question right there.
Done quite a few short recordings, but we've got the best of Charanga del Norte, Sapo Guapo, which is live, and then I've just done two CDs, which are more like my PhD recordings, Our Mam in Havana and Look Back in Charanga.
But you put out a CD of just dance songs?
It was an EP of Danzon in 2001, I think.
Right.
Yeah.
And to get away with that, you know, because I remember when Machito told me, and Orchestra Broadway told me years ago, when things changed in this city and everything was salsa, they were told they weren't playing salsa. And if Broadway got a gig, they would tell them not to play a danzón.
Well, there are salsa clubs, and in the salsa clubs, they don't really like you to play danzón.
Unfortunately.
Yeah, I think it's foolish.
It is.
Well, I joke I think with that the DJ that I do a whole set of danzón.
The movie, Buena Vista Social Club, opened a lot of doors and opened a lot of minds. You know, so we do danzón. We do As Time Goes By from Casablanca.
Oh,
it's beautiful.
I love that.
And it goes into this guajira.
But you get different venues because I go to theatres and art centres and big music venues. So we supported Eliades Ochoa in Bridgewater Hall. They've got a grand Steinway grand. So when we play the danzón, it's really popular because we had a really good piano player, did beautiful solos. And when I've done theatre gigs, people come up and say, oh, what was that number? Oh, it's Isora Club or La Reina Zerén. And it's like, that's beautiful. So you know, it depends. The salsa clubs, you've got to play them sort of more fast kind of dance stuff.
You
but
know,
if you move out to other venues, festivals, you can do a mixture.
You know what's beautiful?
Just one point. I mentioned this to Eddie Zerbegon, the flutist and founder of Orchestra, who's 50 years this summer at Lincoln Center.
Yes, yes.
All right.
Eddie, shout out to you, my friend.
And he told me, he said, I said, I want to end the set with a dance song. He says, don't do it. But he says, Angeloro, in 1971, I was in Senegal, Africa, and I could have played Fafita, the dance song, for 4 hours. And the Africans
and
wouldn't get tired of it.
They would have loved it. You know, it was funny. I was going to say, you know, the charanga begins in Europe. I mean, you know, that's the beginning of it.
And the ensemble came out of Haiti.
Haiti, but originally the you know,
down.
Yeah,
okay,
you know,
dance,
exactly. Yeah. And here we go back to Europe, to England, and here we have Susan Miller, you know, and it's just like a full circle thing, kind of, you know.
Yeah.
It's funny you bring that up. Now Mozart wrote 6 country dances, very short. We're going to take one of them into an ensemble.
Oh,
and
wonderful!
He called it country dances. He was paid to do it for some rich guy's party. Right. 6 country dances.
And when,
it's short and beautiful.
When can we look forward to this?
As soon as we get in the studio and Hadel will finish the arrangements, because she and Louis play a lot of Mozart when they practice. So we're going to turn it into a dance song, one of them.
Excuse me. I guess I had too much wine there, right? Ms. Miller, I want to ask you, will you be coming back anytime soon to the States?
I hope so. I mean, I have benefited from the generosity and hospitality of Eddie Zerbegon twice, because he invited me in 2007 to the Mammal Seal Festival.
Okay.
So I guessed with Orchestra Broadway, where I met Al for the first time.
She played with them at Mammal Seal in New Jersey.
Oh, Mammal Seal, for them, Mammal Seal.
And then Eddie said, you're welcome anytime. And I had to go to San Francisco last week. And I thought, why not stay with Eddie on the way back, because it's an awful long way. So I said, can I stay? And he went, yeah, of course, you're welcome anytime. So whether he'll say that again after I've stayed for a week.
Oh, I'm sure he will.
Rolled in drunk late at night for
Well, listen, I want to say thank you to you, Ms. Miller. Have a wonderful trip back to England. Have a wonderful tour of whatever's left. I don't know how many days you have left on your tour here. I want to thank you, Al.
Well, thank you.
We look
so
forward
glad you,
to
I'm so glad you came.
Listen, I was telling my wife here, you know, I was so excited, you know, because first of all, I never recorded at SOBs, and charanga, we are big charanga lovers. I mean, I used to be a band boy with Pupi Legarreta.
I'm playing with him tomorrow.
Are you playing with Siglo 20?
I'm playing with Pupi
Really?
Legarreta.
Oh, man.
Tomorrow.
Tell him that Manny, tell him that Manny says hello, his first band boy back in the 70s.
Manny.
When Jesse Herrero from Sublime was his lead singer.
Man. Pardon me, I gotta get up.
Wow.
Pardon me.
Okay.
Well, I met Poopy in November in Philadelphia. I was at a conference and I met Orlando Fiol, who's the son of Henry Fiol.
Henry Fiol
took me to Poopy's house, so I met Poopy.
Oh,
and I started
wonderful.
My charanga with some of Poopy's arrangements from his Tumi recording, Me Voy Pamarón and Kikiriki. And my violinist had a dance, a chicken dance, to go with it. So Poopy was instrumental, though he didn't know it, in the first steps of charanga. Norte, so
wonderful. You know,
tomorrow I'm going to play with Poopy, hopefully.
So
if he's
give my regards. Give my regards. Tell him it's Manny, his first band boy.
Manny Santiago. Manny Santiago.
Yeah. Last time I recorded was Festival on 112th Street.
What do you play?
I'm sorry?
What do you play?
I don't know. I'm a frustrated musician. Thank you, Ms. Mello. I appreciate your time.
Well, that's great. It's
may everything go well for you, and we hope to see you again.
Yeah, you will, because I'm obsessed with charanga.
And hello,
sure
Leeds.
I'm coming back.
I'll be upset.
Okay, Al.
Hello, Leeds, England.
Hi, Leeds.
Bye-bye. Thank you.
Thank you.